Hey, welcome back to NBC 25 today. Well, in just a couple of weeks, it is back to school. And for many of us, it's quite a chore getting our kids ready. But this morning, we've got some help for you. Joining us once again, our parenting expert, Thomas Haller. Nice to see you again.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
And well, first of all, some do's and don'ts about getting your kids ready for school. What are they?
Yes, you know, we're all right in that mode, right? You see it all over the TV about getting back to school and getting book bags
right.
and sign of that veneer stuff that we all need to get back. But I want the parents today to think about three areas. You want to get ready physically, you want to get ready emotionally, and you want to get ready mentally.
Okay.
Right? That's what you want to help your kids do. So that's in the do's and don'ts of that, don't wait any longer. Get started now. We're 2-3 weeks away, like you were saying, but this is the time to get started. Don't wait till the weekend before to start addressing some of these issues. So first, physically, we've got the physically getting book bags and pencils mm-hmm. and all that, but also think about physically as far as the schedule for the day. Start pulling back on that bedtime and start getting them up a little bit earlier so that by the time school starts, they're ready.
Okay.
Don't do it the weekend before. Just slowly kind of edge 15 minutes here, 15
okay.
minutes there, pulling that back. And also start looking physically at your routine schedule. When generally do you think they're going to be studying? What will that time of day be? Start pulling back, get the TV turned off, turn off the radio, and have that time of day become quieter. Not oh. saying to your kids, this is study time, we're going to practice study
right,
for school.
Right.
No, but just make it lighter, make it easier, so it starts taking the feel. Now, emotionally, you want to start talking with your children about the school year and how they feel about the school coming up and what they're thinking about friends and getting back to talking positively mm-hmm. about the things they're looking forward to. And this is where you do more listening than talking, because you don't want to interject your goals. It's about their goals.
Their goals, okay.
And it would be the same thing mentally about as you're thinking about school and thinking about what you want to have happen, what would you like to do different this year than you did last year? So both in the emotional and mental stages is you want to get into the feeling parts, and you want to have them do more talking about what they'd like to do different, what they're looking forward to, what they'd like to do the same. And keeping those things, and you can even take them up to school and do another walkthrough if you
sure.
want, and get them to meet the principal again. For the older kids, you're going to want to stay on the positive side of school. Their friends, the clubs mm-hmm. they get back involved with, the sporting events coming up, and get them talking about that and how they want to be. Again, though, remember, it's their goals, and you're going to help them reach their goals. You want to help them feel good about that
okay.
as they head into school in an upswing.
Excellent advice. And I do want to mention you do have a new book coming out in September 1st, The Only Three Discipline Strategies You Will Ever Need, Essential Tools for Busy Parents. And you can learn more by logging on to our website, nbc25online.com. Thomas Haller, thanks again for joining us.
Thank
we
you.
Appreciate it.